So I came up with this analogy. I don't know if this will be useful. This is how I interpret training load. Okay, I consider it like burners on a grill. Okay, if you've got all these burners on a grill, you've got some burners you can play with. You could fire it up, right? You could have it on high, you could have it on low. These are the things that I attempt to manipulate as a coach. Some of those things are not totally in my control, but I attempt to manipulate, right? How much volume we're doing, how much intensity, the frequency of that, right? Skill development from day one, right? Can you effectively express your aerobic capacity through running economy? Race specificity, which is obviously related to intensity and volume, but I would differentiate because as we get closer to May, we are definitely getting more and more race specific, adding more races, obviously. I 100% believe that races are training. I couldn't care less if we ever won an invitational at any point in a track season. Emotional arousal, cognitive arousal. So how emotionally invested are they right now? How focused are they right now? Freshmen coming out for cross country, those last two, I am attempting to fire them up and turn those dials as much as possible because they don't have those two, right? They're not sure if they want to do this in some cases. They certainly don't have a lot of focus on the skill of running. They've never been introduced to it. So I'm like trying to fire them up. I would do the exact opposite with seniors who are fully committed to our team. We're actually trying to dial that emotional level down on the first day of practice in August, right? So this is kind of how I see it. If you have all these things fired up all the time, that could be a problem. So, but as a coach, you can manipulate these dials a bit. Emotional arousal, you can manipulate that, right? And I'll kind of talk about that to a degree. Scott Christensen's in the audience, which is super intimidating for me. But kind of related to this, this is a study, he actually just wrote about this and his study was out, I saw. So in this study, the conclusions were the one differentiating factor that led to an athlete's performance in a middle distance event, 800, 1500 in this metric, the differentiating factor was max sprint speed, right? If you're measuring everything else. And I truly subscribe to the Vince Anderson idea that speed creates endurance. The faster you are at a maximum speed, the easier you're able to sustain speeds relative to that for longer periods of time, right? Because it's simply not as much of, not a degree of your max speed. So we're hyper committed to that.